evening on Haus Home, BSB gives us the update for the month of July. We take a few pointers on sewing, which will come very handy for those who are currently taking a few lessons on how to sew. And we join Jane over at Brian Bell with an interesting piece of technology that purifies the air from airborne mould and virus. So if you're one that has allergies to dust or dust mites, you no longer need to suffer the effects. A very good evening to you all and welcome to Haus Home. I'm certain most of you, if not all of you, had an eventful weekend. And lucky you, to those that got away for the weekend, nothing like a bit of self-rejuvenating before the long week ahead, and I hope it hasn't started off too bad for most of you. Coming up, BSB has had a busy month themselves. Here they are, their update for the month of July.
BSB FPOS, now in more locations to make your purchases even easier. Use BSP FPOS to save you carrying cash around. But if you need some cash, you can always get it using your Kundu card at one of thousands of BSP FPOS merchants across the country. Wherever you are, there is a BSP FPOS facility nearby, so you can access your money anytime. While travelling, use BSP FPOS to pay for airfares, hotels and meals. Because BSP FPOS is the smarter way to pay.
Good evening, viewers, and welcome to another BSP update. Financial inclusion is something that BSP takes very seriously, and it was for this reason that the bank supported the BPNG Financial Inclusion Expo 2014 as gold sponsor. The expo, which was held in Kokopo, East New Britain province, provided the opportunity for our customers to gain an insight into BSP's products and services. The expo also provided an opportunity for customers to attend information sessions on how BSP could assist them in building their financial footprint. The expo was a resounding success, with numerous schools also visiting our stall and inquiring about services such as mobile banking, internet banking, as well as the ever-popular Sumatin account. Big thank you to the BSP Rabaul and Kokopo teams for helping to make the BPNG Financial Inclusion Expo a success. Now on to sponsorships. City Mission PNG, a leading Christian-based non-profit charity organization, has received a major boost towards its programs. BSP recently presented 5,000 kina to the organization as part of its ongoing annual support. BSP appreciate the role City Mission has contributed to PNG, especially in providing a home and training to destitute boys in the country, and the bank's continued support is testament to this. As City Mission PNG prepares to celebrate its 20th anniversary, BSP is just as proud to be associated with the mission over the years. City Mission PNG Chief Executive Officer Reverend Ronald Brown, when receiving the check, acknowledged and commended BSP for their continued support to helping youth in the mission with various projects. Another organization which received assistance this month from BSP was Salvation Army. The salvos were presented 20,000 kina as support for the Red Shield appeal. BSP Group Chief Executive Officer Robin Fleming, when presenting the bank's support to Salvation Army, emphasized the important role that the salvos continue to play in the country. The Salvation Army is one frontline organization that meets the needs of Papua New Guineans in their various programs, and BSP is pleased to assisting to continue the wonderful work that they are doing. The Red Shield appeal has been in existence for almost 30 years, having commenced during the early 1980s. As the slogan for the 2014 Red Shield appeal is Educating the Nation, most funds from this year's appeal will be channeled to the Koki Secondary School in Port Moresby. Senior Audit Officer Kathy Pataturana, when presenting the sponsorship, reaffirmed the bank's continued support and said BSP is happy to support a professional body that promotes international standards of best practice. This is the 10th year the conference has been hosted and will be held in Port Moresby from August 6th to 7th, with presentations from local and overseas speakers. Topics at the conference will include internal auditing, corporate governance, and impacts of global crisis. BSP has increased in sponsorship support of Port Moresby Nature Park to gold sponsor in recognition of the contribution made by the Nature Park to promoting environmental awareness programs in the community. BSP Bank is committed to environmental initiatives through its Go Green program, and we see this sponsorship as further contributing to green initiatives and in raising community awareness on how each of us can play a part in protecting the environment. Earlier this year, BSP Bank provided cash contributions of 35,000 kina towards the construction of a new hornbill enclosure which is currently being built in the lead-up to the 2015 Pacific Games. The aim is to showcase the hornbill as one talks to Tura, the 2015 Pacific Games official mascot, within new internationally accredited exhibits. Speaking of Tura and the Pacific Games, the month of July also marked 1 year to go to the 2015 Pacific Games. The 1 year to go was celebrated with a motorcade around Port Moresby, as well as the unveiling of digital billboards counting down to the official opening ceremony. The Pacific Games will take place from July 4th to the 18th, 2015, and is sure to be a highlight for PNG. With athletes from across the Pacific looking forward to the 2015 Pacific Games in Port Moresby, the host organizing committee has been working around the clock to ensure preparations for the Pacific Games are on track. Work on the venues that will be used for the 2015 Pacific Games is progressing well, with construction work continuing and on track for completion prior to the opening ceremony. During the 2015 Pacific Games, the spotlight will be on PNG, and it is hoped these venues will leave a legacy for many more years to come. BSP is also naming rights sponsor for the 6th PNG Games. To be held in November in Leh, Morobe Province, organizers of the BSP PNG Games are also working hard to ensure that all venues in Leh are ready to welcome athletes from around the country. Over 9,000 athletes from 22 provinces are expected to converge on Leh come November. 28 sports at 19 venues have been confirmed for these games. Apart from this, staff from our branches continue to drive the community projects around the country. The bank's operations SBU recently renovated the City Mission Mary Safe House in Kaugere. Victims of domestic violence who seek care and counseling at the City Mission-run Mary Safe House will now have access to increased comfort and safety, courtesy of Bank South Pacific. Through the bank's community projects initiatives, staff from BSP's operations SBU volunteered their spare time to assisting City Mission in giving a new lease of life to the Mary Safe House. This community project was officially handed over to City Mission PNG by the bank's head of international operations, Marilyn Sampson. Over the last 3 months, staff from BSP operations were more than happy to volunteer their time to assist in bringing a new lease of life to Mary Safe House at Kaugere, as well as to House Ruth at Ella Beach. Work undertaken included the upgrading of rooms to allow more women to sleep in comfort, as well as the installation of new furniture and white goods throughout House Ruth at Ella Beach. Both centers have also benefited from increased security, with the bank also installing more secure locks throughout these facilities. BSP Booker also successfully completed its community project, with the project handed over on the weekend. The new look Hujena basketball courts is sure to be a hive of activity, thanks to our staff from BSP Booker who sacrificed their time to assist in renovating this facility. More community projects are being undertaken in many other branches throughout Papua New Guinea, with more handovers planned in the coming months. Finally, this evening, we want to wish our Paralympians all the best as they commence competition at the Commonwealth Games currently underway in Glasgow. BSP is proud to be a major sponsor of the Paralympics team, and we look forward to positive performances from members of Team PNG. Also attending the Commonwealth Games are BSP brand ambassadors Ryan Pinney and Toya Whistle, who no doubt will be supporting them as well. And that concludes our BSP update for July. Until the next time, enjoy your viewing. Good night.
BSP FPOS, now in more locations to make your purchases even easier. Use BSP FPOS to save you carrying cash around. But if you need some cash, you can always get it using your Kundu card at one of thousands of BSP FPOS merchants across the country. Wherever you are, there is a BSP FPOS facility nearby, so you can access your money anytime. While travelling, use BSP FPOS to pay for airfares, hotels and meals. Because BSP FPOS is the smarter way to pay.
One thing about BSP is that they have set up various bank account plans to suit the different and growing customer needs. For instance, the Sumatin card, which is set up for the students, which I think is a great idea. It's user-friendly and it has proven quite handy for the tertiary students. Their family can also deposit directly into the Sumatin account instead of sending it via post office or other similar means. After the break, we take a look at some tips on sewing. In the this segment, we take a closer look on sewing, which is the craft of fastening and attaching objects with a needle and thread. Well, right here with me, I've got the lovely Vivienne and Gorothy. They're from YWCA, and they will tell us more about sewing and the processes while sewing your favorite product.
I started sewing in high school, but then when I completed high school, I have to have a certificate in order to get advanced knowledge in sewing. So I ended up working under, I came to YWCA, and I was trained under Vivian. We get lots of clients who come with their own patterns, their designs, and we do them for them. Just recently we did SP Sports Awards committees, their shirts and ladies' tops, and PNG Olympics.
All mama lo country, so was tipla like some map. Ipla can come lo wider say, or some map lo training. Ipla come looking me or Gorothy.
I just want to encourage mothers out there who are listening. It's fast money in this sewing project. So we have to get something to, you know, make income or for our families. Nowadays it's hard. It's hard, so we don't have to waste time playing cards or just roam around the street. We have to create something for our living in the city.
Sewing is the craft of fastening or attaching objects using stitches made with a needle and thread. Sewing is one of the oldest of the textile arts, arising in the Paleolithic era. Before the invention of spinning yarn or weaving fabric, archaeologists believe Stone Age people across Europe and Asia sewed fur and skin clothing using bone, antler or ivory needles and thread made of various animal body parts, including catgut and veins. Although usually associated with clothing and household linens, sewing is used in a variety of crafts and industries, including shoemaking, upholstery, sail making, book binding, and the manufacturing of some kinds of sporting goods. Sewing is the fundamental process underlying a variety of textile arts and crafts, including embroidery, tapestry, quilting, applique, and patchwork. For thousands of years, all sewing was done by hand. The invention of the sewing machine in the 19th century and the rise of computerization in the later 20th century led to mass production of sewing objects, but hand sewing is still practiced around the world. Fine hand sewing is a characteristic of high quality tailoring and custom dressmaking and is pursued by both textile artists as a means of creative expression. Clothing technology has evolved to a complicated science weighed against the labor cost, making positive and negative effects across the globe. Millions of women in Bangladesh and other developing countries have come out of poverty working as sewing machine operators. Chain stitch, made with one thread. Lock stitch, made with two threads in any of these geometries. Straight stitch, zigzag stitch including blind stitch, stretch stitch, overlock made with 1 to 4 threads, cover stitch made with 2 or 4 threads. A pattern in sewing and fashion design is the paper or cardboard template from which the parts of a garment are traced onto fabric before cutting out and assembling, sometimes called paper patterns. Pattern making or pattern cutting is the science of designing patterns. A custom fitted basic pattern from which patterns from many different styles can be created is called a sloper. Home sewing patterns are generally printed on tissue paper and sold in packets containing sewing instructions and suggestions for fabric and trim. Home sewers can print the patterns at home or take the electronic file to a business that does copying and printing. And finally, when it comes to sewing, modern patterns are available in a wide range of prices, sizes, and the sewing skill levels just to meet the needs of the consumers. Hope you enjoyed. More on House and Home in a moment. Welcome back. You're watching Haus Home if you just tuned in. We all know the importance of education and need to strive to ensure that all our children in Papua New Guinea get the chance at learning to read and to write. In order for that to happen, childhood learning plays an important part in preparing the children, introducing them to basic learning, and it all starts with storytelling, nursery rhymes, songs, pictures, and numbers with the introduction to books. Here's a feature story on a particular not-for-profit organization based in Port Moresby, which has established children's libraries and continues to foster a love of reading and learning. Book Belong Pikinini.
Only half of school-aged children go to school, and the literacy rate in PNG is well under 50%, as officially claimed. In some areas, it's as low as 5%. What is the right school age for children?
Our libraries, we are getting 4 to 5 and 6 year old, because our organization is dealing with most vulnerable children which don't have the opportunity to go to preschool or other schools that parents were not able to afford this fees and all this. So we were targeting for those kids, and you will see that our libraries are most getting those children from the settlement.
Book Belong Pikinini was established in 2007 and has so far up to several children libraries. In how many libraries do you have in and around Port Moresby, and are there any in other centers?
Yeah, sure. We have 8 at the moment, and 2 is just about to open, 1 at Tatana, and 1 is coming up at ATS. And we have 4 in regions. We have 3 in regional regions. That one is not yet opening, but 2 other trees are running. One up at Goroka at the Bed of Paradise Hotel. They were one of those. Yeah, yes. And one is Lei University, and the other one is at Eriku. But we have one coming up at University of Goroka, but there's something that need to be get it organized so it will be open soon.
So a lot of growth since 2007 for Book Belong Pikinini. How are Book Belong Pikinini libraries different to other libraries?
Actually, we are the library and we are not a school. Most people think that we are a school, but our aim is to make these little kids, they have to know how to read this early age before they go to schools. So we use a jolly phonics approach in our libraries. We teach them sound, and then they master the 42 sounds, and then we put them on the base one level, and they started reading from there until up to level 5, and they are ready, so we send them to elementaries.
Yeah. So it's more a preparation that you do, and it's not so much a school, but it's to encourage them to read, encourage them to love books and want to read, correct?
So yeah, therefore, our aim is to make them to fall in love with books. So we encourage books in our library. So we read as much books they have to read at this age before they go to school. So we have some very good, amazing stories happen in this 3-year-old, 4-year-old. They can read very confident at this age. And parents were really amazed to see that. And the syllables that we offered is very expensive, but they pay nothing and it's free. Yeah.
What is one success story that comes to mind? One example of one child that you, from the top of your head, that you think of is a good success story?
Yes, we have most such a story in our libraries, but there are a few that I can let you know. Some of these 4-year-old, 5-year-old, they can read very confident with 5 to 6 textbooks with a level of grade 2 or grade 3 can read, but a 4-year-old and 6-year-old can read. So when they go to elementary and they do a diagnosis test, and the teachers at elementary, they see that they were above the level that they expected, they always push them straight to grade 4 and grade 5. And there's some of the amazing stories that we have in our libraries.
Fantastic. And I understand, I learned just today when we were chatting before this interview, that there is a Book Belong Papa Mama too, where you encourage the parents to learn along with their children so they can continue this learning at home. Tell us a bit about that.
Yes, of course, because the mothers that are sending their kids home, some of them are illiterate, they cannot read. So for them to help their kids is very hard. So we encourage the mothers to come to the library, they sit with their kids and they learn the sounds, they do the blending, they do segmenting, and they started to together with their kids. So in that way, because the kids, they learn very fast, at times, if they're more advancing, then they help their mothers again. If a mother's by chance, then they learn fast, then they help their child again in reading. So so we encourage mothers to come, and they also learn with their kids.
Fantastic. A lot of the work that you do is preparation for schools. What advice do you have for just parents out there who are parents or guardians, bubus, those that stay at home with the kids?
Coming from a teacher background, I've been teaching in some of these private schools, and the syllables that Bukbulam Pekinini is offering, I see that it's a bit very expensive, but coming to our level where it's really free, where if you send a child to IE schools or other schools, private schools, you pay thousands and thousands of money for that particular child to get, you know, get educated. But I see that there is great opportunity, and parents need to see that it's like what this organization is doing, it's just offering free for them. So I normally go out doing awareness on parents who are there. I said, bring your child and let them learn, because it's the opportunity, and opportunity comes at once. And this organization is here for us and is here to stay. So as we Papua New Guineans, we have to benefit, and it's an opportunity.
For our viewers watching that would like to help, how can they help Bukbulam Pekinini with the work that you're doing?
I think it's very important. The other organization and donors, they think that very important thing that what Bukbulam Pekinini is doing, and they donate books, they donate kind like cash and all these things into our library to support this, to continue on. So I like to encourage our government to look into this one as well, because most of our elementary kids there are not able to read at this age, and some of the kids that the government cannot cater for them at the age of 4 to 5 and 6 years. The government only they only allow funds for the 7-year-old where they go to elementary and they started, but they forget about these ones. But because it's very important that they learn at age very fast, because their minds are like sponges, I think what we're doing is, I think it's very important for Papua New Guineans to see. It's very important, what I say, it's very important, because early childhood, most people think that the kids go to school at this early age, at 7 and 8, and they learn things, but they forget about this very early age, the ages 4-year-old, 5-year-old, and 6-year-old, where they learn very fast at this age. And to make them, to build them a better citizen of this nation, I think is through reading. If you want to be an educated person, if you want to be whatever, you have to start early age. And the foundation of reading and understanding and learning is through reading. So we believe in reading, so that's why this organization is here, to make as much opportunity available for the unfortunate Papua New Guineans to have their opportunities to read, so that they can, as they continue to their education, they are better learners for tomorrow.
Childhood learning is definitely a key to literacy, and it starts with a book. It doesn't matter how young your child is, you can start by reading children's books to them as young as a year older, or even as babies if you'd like, at home. Children develop faster when you read to them or allow them to watch educational learning material at the earliest age possible. By doing this, you are nurturing their ability to learn more as they get older. Visual educational material allows a toddler to recognize basic shapes, everyday objects, colors, numbers, and letters, and sounding of letters, which encourages speech and pronunciation of words. When they're at the age to attend preschool, not only will they be at an advantage, but it encourages them to excel and them wanting to learn more. There are many children books available. Why not start a library for your own little one in your own home? For those that would like to make donations of books to Book Belong Pikinini, you can pay a visit at either of the libraries. The featured here in Haus Home is located within the campus of the University of PNG. Now, dust in homes, in cars, in the workplace is always a problem, and to some, it can be quite detrimental to one's health. Where there is dust, be certain there are dust mites. They can be quite a pest contributing to your allergies. But there's a certain technology that purifies the air, preventing airborne mold and viruses caused by dust or dust mites. Do you want to know what it is? You get to find out right after these messages when we join Jane over at Brian Bell.
Hello viewers, and welcome to another episode of Haus Home with Brian Bell. I'm Jane Tokilala. Did you know that mites breed and multiply by eating molds and pieces of human skin? Consuming human waste is not a bad practice, but the real problem here is that dust mite feces, which will eventually become airborne allergens, which creates allergies. That is why tonight I will introduce the plasma cluster technology, which is air purifying technology that inactivates suspended airborne viruses and molds. For example, when the plasma cluster ions are released into the air, they attack airborne microbes like viruses and molds by removing and breaking down proteins from their surfaces, which are then returned to the air as water. This gives you a fresh, clean, and healthy air to breathe. Now, this process shows how effective and safe these products are. Therefore, these products are a must-have for homes that have children, particularly babies or toddlers, homes with domestic pets, smokers' home, offices, or anyone who desires pure, clean, and healthy hair. We have available Singer and Sharp brands with different model names, like the FUA28E, which is high-density PCI generator and fan. Is user-friendly with the on-off modes, has got three option buttons. The air purifier can cover a floor size of about 19 square meters, and the high-density PCI can cover a floor size of about 16 square meters. Has got a fan indicator speed and has three fan speed mode, which are maximum, medium, and low. Has got a filter life of up to 2 years and weighs about 3.4 kilograms. FUZ31E is high density PCI generator and fan. Is user friendly with the on-off modes. Has got three operation buttons. The air purifier can cover a floor size of about 21 square meters, and the high density PCI can cover a floor size of about 13 square meters. Has got four fan speed mode, which are automatic, maximum, medium, and low. It is odor sensor and has a clean sign indicator. Has got a filter life of up to 2 years and weighs about 5 kilograms. This next product, the KC-A40E, is an air purifier with humidifying functions. Has high density PCI generator and fan. Is user friendly with the on-off modes. The air purifier can cover a floor size of about 26 square meters without humidifying, about 21 square meters with humidifying, and the high density PCI can cover a floor size of about 21 square meters as well. Has got five fan speed mode of automatic, pollen, maximum, medium, and low. Has got a filter life of up to 10 years and weighs about 8.1 kilograms. This next product, the IGDL-1E, is suitable for night sleeping, which can remove suspended viruses and other contaminants. This product includes a stand and a clamp, which can be installed to the headboard of the bed or to the side table. However, to enable stable emission of high-density plasma cluster ions, the generating unit has to be replaced every 2 years. Other convenient products would include the portable air cons. They're easy to transport and can be moved from one room to another. Before I wrap up, I know I featured furniture in my last segment, but just for your information, we have now available the new LB wooden beds. Made from high-grade rubber wood, it comes in a range of single, double, king bed, bed bunk, and family bunk at reasonable prices and in various sizes for the whole family to enjoy. So remember, great products, great prices. That's Brian Bell. Until next time, I'm Jane Tokilala. Have a good night.
Best quality, guaranteed, at Brian Bell.
Right on, Mr. B.
That plasma cluster technology will definitely come in handy, especially for those that have carpet in their homes, office, or even in cars. And I agree with Jane, the air purifier is a must to have because you have smokers around you at home or in the office, and even more so when you have babies or toddlers or having house pets. More on House and Home in a moment. Welcome back. Are you one that suffers with having dark circles around the eyes? For most of us, it's generally the lack of care for ourselves. We allow ourselves to stress and not to do something about it. We get caught up with our evening activities and find ourselves not allowing ourselves the required 8 hours sleep our body needs. We are always in a rush, hence we do not take the time to eat proper meal at breakfast especially. Besides the dark circles around the eyes, many of us have also developed the unwanted puffy eyes that just won't either go or won't go away fast enough. I know quite a few of women out there would definitely be able to relate to this. Puffy or swollen eyes is usually caused by fluid retention, stress, allergies, hormone changes, and other factors. Crying is often accompanied by swollen eyes because of the tiny glands in the eyelids that produce tears, become inflamed from overactivity. Also, from time to time, we can get puffy eyes after sleeping. This can be caused by too much sodium in the diet, which causes water retention. Puffy eyes can also be caused by lack of sleep or excessive alcohol intake. Now, how can one reduce swelling from normal puffy eyes that are not caused by eye conditions such as conjunctivitis, styes, allergies, or other eye infections? There are quite a number of natural remedies that really do work, and here are just a few that I found that gives me the results I want. Refrigerate a small potato for about an hour at the least, take out and slice into two halves, and then gently place each half over your eyes for 15 to 20 minutes, but make sure that the potatoes also covers the puffed areas under your eyes. You should notice a tremendous change in those bags under your eyes as they end up diminished in size. Cucumbers are also a fantastic natural remedy to get rid of under-eye puffiness. Take two slices of fresh refrigerated cucumber and place on your eyes for 25 minutes. This also allows you to relax as well, as it helps refresh your mind as well as your eyes, and the anti-inflammatory properties of the cool cucumber will naturally help reduce puffy tissue. Green tea also works. Relax with a damped, chilled green tea bag over each eye. The natural properties of green tea will help bring puffy eyes back to their original size. Also, if you're in the hurry and don't want to go with droopy eyes, then the normal tea bags are also the way to go. Just moisten two tea bags in cold water, refrigerate them for a while, and lie back and place them over your eyes for 25 to 30 minutes. Wash your eyes and face with cold water and dry your skin well. You'd feel relaxed and rejuvenated. I am aware that some have used chilled milk for extremely puffy eyes, beaten egg whites, and ice packs even. So take note of these remedies as they may prove quite useful for you. I mentioned earlier that stress, again, can be effective for causing puffy eyes. So exercise regularly, but ensure before you take up any vigorous activities, also get a medical checkup first and have your blood pressure checked. It's good to know and see that many women are not making exceeded effort to take better care of themselves, whether it be losing weight, exercising to get fit, eating the right foods and a whole lot of less of junk foods, taking pride in the dressing or basically attending to their overall appearance and looking a lot more well-groomed than usual. keep it up. Not only you do look good, but you will feel better for yourself and have more energy to get through your day. If for some reason symptoms don't improve and you're doing everything right, then I do urge you to please do see a doctor for a full medical checkup, like I mentioned, especially your blood pressure. You may have an imbalance of something that may require medication, but nevertheless, exercising should be encouraged and keeping your fluids up is also very helpful. Lots of water to keep you hydrated, especially here in PNG when it gets pretty humid. So get in the habit of eating well, well rested, regular exercising, and a good fluid intake. More on Haus Home, so stay with us. Welcome back. We've just come to an end of Haus Home for this evening. Next week, Chef Ferry is back in our Haus Home kitchen making a simple zanak egg and mustard mayonnaise, something those who prefer homemade mayonnaise as opposed to buying off the shelf to watch out for. And we join Jane and the team over at Brian Bell featuring another fantastic quality buy at an affordable price range. This is where the Haus Home team and I will leave you. Here's a wishing you a very pleasant evening, and may the remainder of the week ahead be a productive and a satisfying one. Until next week, keep on the journey to a healthier you with those regular exercises, enjoying the outdoors, and keep eating right. Good night.